Shruti Shishu Kunj, Vagwala Bursad, English medium, standard 4th subject maths. As you all know that we are still going on with the chapter number 11, tables and shares. Today we will see the word problems with repeated subtraction. Repeated subtraction method we have already seen in the second standard, okay, and in third standard also in division chapter. Fine. So let's try to solve the word problems over here. The first word problem is Kanu made a necklace of 17 seashells. Kanu had used 17 seashells in a one necklace. Okay. How many such necklaces can be made using 100 seashells? He is having 100 seashells and he want to make necklaces. He had used 17 seashells in each necklace. So let's find out using the repeated subtraction method of division. Fine. So as we know that 100, right? 100 minus 17, we will get 83. Okay. After that, take this 83 here. Again minus with 17 means he is making the another necklace. It remains 66 now. Take this 66, minus it again with 17. You will get 49. Okay. Now take this 49 and subtract it with 17. You will get here 32. Again take this 32, subtract it with 17. At last we have here 15. If you will see, this 15 is less than 17, right? So we cannot subtract it now. We have to keep this 15 as it is. If we will count this, how many steps are there? We don't have to count this 15, okay, right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. From this we can say that 4 necklaces Kanu had made and 15 seashells were left over as it is. Okay, so this is our answer. In a sentence form, let's write down. Kanu made 4 necklaces and 15 seashells were left over. Clear, everyone? It's very easy and simple thing if you revise it yourself then. Okay, let's see number 2. One carton can hold 85 soap bars. Shelley wants to pack 338 soap bars in a one box, we can say one box or one carton. 85 soap bars are there and Shelley have 338 soap bars. Okay, so she has to pack all of them. So the question is there, how many cartons does she need for packing all of them? How much cartons she needed to pack all that soap bars? For that, again we need to do subtraction, repeated subtraction. You can use here division sum also if you know that. Okay, it's not important that you have to do use only repeated subtraction. But if you will see, then repeated subtraction method is easy for you for this. So let's solve it. 338 minus 85 is equal to, what you will get is 253. 253 you will get it. Now take this 252 here and subtract it with 85. You will get answer 168. Okay. 168. Now take this 168 here, subtract it with 85. What you will get answer is 83. Okay, now see, this 83 is less than 85, so we cannot do the subtraction. Okay, 83 is less than 85, so we cannot subtract them. Fine. So same as the first one, we will write the answer that Shelley need 3 cartons to pack all the soap bars. We have to pack these 83 soap bars also. So Shelley need 3 cartons to pack all these soap bars. So let's write answer. Shelley needs 3 cartons. Need 3 cartons to pack all the soap bars. Just take a look. Let's move towards number 3 word problem. The question is, Manpreet wants 1500 sacks of cement for making a house. A truck carries 250 sacks at a time. How many trips will truck make? Here the word sacks means bag. Okay, the big bags were also called as sacks. So you can say this word as a bag also. Okay, so Manpreet wants 1500 bags of cement to make a house, and a truck carries at a time 250 bags only, big bags of cement. Okay, so what we have to do here, first let's write down that one truck is equal to 250 sacks. Okay, so how many trip will be there? Here you can write trip also instead of truck. Question mark. Truck's trip, fine, is equal to 1550 sacks of cement. So here if you will see, then it's a cross multiplication. So you can see that therefore 1500 divided by 250. Okay, if you will see, then you can cancel these zero zeros, right? So it remains here 150 divided by 25. When you divide this 100, if you will see, then you can see that 150 you will get as 30 faiza also, and 25 you get as 5 faiza, right? So we can cancel this 5 5, and when we all know that 5 30 is there in the table of 5, when 5 6 are 30. Okay, so our answer is here 6. At last we can write that 6 trips the truck makes to carry 1500 sacks of cement. Clear? Now there is another question regarding this word problem. As you can see here, a truck driver charges rupees 500 for a trip. When a truck driver is going at one time, he is taking 500 rupees. So we know that truck driver is going to take 6 trips, right? In a 6 trip he will carry 1500 bags of cement. So how many rupees that truck driver will charge to Manpreet? Means Manpreet will pay how many rupees to the driver? That we need to find. So here we have to do the multiplication of the 6 number which we got as a 6 trips, right? 6 trips with the 1 trip charge. Okay, so we can say that 6 trips is equal to question mark rupees, right? 1 trip is equal to rupees 500. From this we can say that therefore rupees 500 multiplied by 6 is equal to, we know that 5 6 are 30, right? two zeros are there here with 5. So write down that here as it is. Here is your answer, that 3000 rupees will be paid by Manpreet to the truck driver. Let's write the answer. Manpreet will pay rupees 3000 to the truck driver. Okay, just take a look. I hope that it is clear for you, these three word problems. Okay, few word problems we have already seen in the word problem. Don't forget to do these word problems in your notebook and send me your homework. Okay, thank you.